Let's talk about corporates, Carborundum Universal. The case for a chat for getting the management, well, the earnings, revenues up about 12.3%, net profit up about 17%. And compared to last year, this was the numbers, it was aided by an improved performance in the abrasives and the ceramics business. Margins, however, saw a marginal decline. Let's discuss some of the factors behind the same with Mr. K Srinivasan. He's the managing director of Carborundum Universal, joins us right now on the show. Mr. Srinivasan, always good having you. Thanks so much for joining in. Neeraj, good morning. How would you sum up the quarter? What led to a small decline in margins? This is in a bit of a contrast compared to what I thought would happen based on the conversation that we had the last quarter.
That's right. So let me start by saying that it was a good quarter except for the fact that we had the floods in Kerala, which took away almost 3% margin on the electro-mineral business. We had our hydroelectric power station. It is still down. It's down since 15th August, and it took away about 5 crores of my business out there. Otherwise, it was tracking well. I mean, we have stayed on to the price increase. We have not tried to buy market share. Our margins are up in abrasives. Our margins are holding in ceramic. Overall margin is down simply because we lost 3% on the electro-mineral business, not coming out of the business, but coming out of external environment reasons, but we should be okay by Q3 and Q4. Overall consolidated sale up to 655 crore, largely because all the other geographies are doing well. Russia is doing well, Europe is doing well, US is doing well. So we are on track to do what we expect for the year.
So that would be what about, if I'm not wrong, and if I don't remember wrongly, about a 15% top-line growth at margins which are between 17 to 19%?
Absolutely. So we should expect to do about 2,700 plus on consolidated top-line and a PAT of about 2,700 crores, 270 crores.
270 crores, okay. Now, albeit the base on the ceramics business is lower than the abrasives or the electro-mineral segment, but that's shown about a 19% growth this time around. What's the volume growth that you saw within the ceramics business, and what's the guidance for the rest of the year?
Ceramic will continue to do well. The margins are good. The sales top line growth is good. Large part of this growth is happening outside of India. It's happening in Europe, US, Australia. Mineral determined, green energy determined businesses, and all of them are doing very well. The refractory part of the business in India is also doing well, though the margins are not as good in that. So the ceramic business, I think this 19% plus should hold on. Surprisingly, also the EBIT margin is also about 19%. So it's sort of, it's a 19% growth top line and a 19% EBIT margin, giving a significant profit growth.
What is this? Is all the growth that is happening, Mr. Srinivasan, a factor of volumes moving up dramatically, or is it a combination of volumes and some price uptick that would have happened?
The price uptake effect you would see more and more because there's been a significant cost increase. We have started putting up prices very aggressively in the electro-mineral business to cover the cost, and that's getting pushed into the abrasives and the refractory as well. At the moment, a significant part of the margin growth you're seeing really is coming out of both volume and product mix. We're getting more and more of the high-value products to be sold in Europe and US, and that's really putting up sales and margins.
Okay. A couple of updates. Before I get those updates, what about the price hikes? Will you undertake any further price hikes going into the second half of the year?
Absolutely. We expect electro-mineral business in the next 2 to 3 quarters to go up by at least 20%. So it's going to be a very significant cost push, largely coming up from the electro-mineral raw material like zircon sand, bauxite, electricity, fuel prices all going up. So there's going to be a significant cost push which has to be passed on to the market. This return has to go through abrasives, refractories to the final consumer. So it's going to be a battle for the next 3 quarters because this kind of price increase going through the systems is generally difficult, and people immediately tend to downtrade. They go to cheaper products as soon as prices go up. But we will have to push it through the system in the next 3 quarters.
Okay. The couple of launches, you are launching, I think, zirconia-based products, if I'm pronouncing the name correctly, in quarter 3, which will probably be, as the note suggests, a lot more cost-efficient. Can you tell us more about this and what do you expect this to do for you?
Yeah. The Z450 is a cost-efficient zirconia. It is our patented product, done largely in South Africa, but the technology is developed here. And that is now scaling up. We were battling with it for almost 3 quarters. For the first time, we're going to probably track about 400 to 500 tons in this quarter, Q3. And this should make a dramatic difference to the profitability and the opportunities in Fosca zirconia. As you know, Fosca zirconia is still not doing well, but hopefully from Q3, we should start doing well.
Interesting. The other bit is the graphene-based product, which was supposed to be launched. What's the status check there?
The graphene-based project really is what I call as the alpha trial. It is really small scale at this stage, 10 kilos a day. But this is a very valuable material. It would have significant impact in not only our businesses, but also related businesses like battery energy storage devices, etc. We have started doing the commercial trial. We should have commercial sales happening probably in Q4.
Okay. If all of this is happening, Mr. Srinivasan, and you're talking about the electro-mineral segment, the volume growth pushing as high as 20%, if I'm not wrong, if I didn't hear you wrongly.
Price increase
is about 20%, excuse me. Are we being a bit conservative when we're talking about this 15-odd% top-line growth? I mean, do you reckon you want to under-promise and over-deliver at best?
I believe that should be a better way to do things because, like you know, there are a lot of imponderables out there, and we're trying to be a little conservative, but very, very good things ahead.
Okay. One last question. Would heightened trade war fears or actual trade wars, I mean, Bloomberg is reporting about U.S. readying for some more tariffs on China come December. If that all were to play out, would it impact growth for you as a company too?
It would actually be beneficial. Sorry to say that, but it's true that as it is today, there is a 10% duty on mineral imports from China, which is mean that the U.S. is trying to buy more from us. And if it goes to 25% as threatened, then there will be more shifting of buying from India. So in a way, though, we don't want to be seen as benefiting from some other war, but I think there are bigger opportunities and greater chances for us to do export more into the U.S. going forward.